Hello, I'm Ty Mason of thediabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today I'm going to answer the question, is beetroot good for diabetes? But before we get into that, make sure you download my free diabetes management book, which also includes a diabetes grocery shopping guide, foods to eat and avoid, by clicking the link below. Now I'm going to say right up front that I am not a beet fan. I have tried them, and I personally don't like them. But I always put my bias aside when looking at foods for others. That being said, let's take a look at the beetroot, or more commonly called the beet. The beet is a taproot portion of the beet plant. Other than a food, beets have been used as food coloring and as a medicinal plant. Beetroot has been used for treatments of a variety of conditions for centuries. They have especially been seen to aid in illness relating to digestion and blood. Now, beets contain ALA, alpha-lipoic acid, a very powerful antioxidant which has been shown to lower blood glucose levels, increase insulin sensitivity, and prevent oxidative stress-induced changes in patients with diabetes. A 2011 study at the University of British Columbia concluded that specifically in diabetes, ALA prevents beta cell destruction, enhances glucose uptake, and its antioxidant effects may be particularly useful in slowing the development of diabetic complications such as diabetic retinopathy. Another aspect of diabetes that needs to be controlled is blood pressure. In 2013, the Journal of Nutrition conducted a review of evidence from 16 trials, including a total of 254 participants. These studies concluded that drinking beetroot juice was linked with a significant reduction in systolic blood pressure levels. While the findings are encouraging, there also needs to be more long-term studies, according to the review. Well, so far, so good. One of the main problems of diabetes, as we have discussed before, is diabetic neuropathy, which causes numbness and tingling in various parts of the body, especially the extremities. Beets have the ability to help slow down the damages as a result of neuropathy. Now, how about the beet from a nutritional standpoint? Well, beets are very low in calories with only 58 per cup serving. They are very low in saturated fat and cholesterol. They're a good source of vitamin C, iron, and magnesium, and a very good source of dietary fiber, folate, potassium, and manganese. Beets have a medium glycemic index at 64. They have a low glycemic load at 5.8. So are beets good for diabetes? I say yes, they are. The beneficial properties and the low GI make them a good addition to your plate. I hope this answers your question, is beetroot good or bad for diabetes? Don't forget to get your diabetes management book by clicking the link in the description box below. And as always, let me know if you have any other further diabetes-related questions. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.